When you hear a show tune from the Great White Way, does a shiver run through ya? Well, we're giving them to ya. Sing hallelujah and shout hooray. Come on along and listen to Broadway to Main Street, USA.
Ding dong, the bells are gonna chime. Pull out the stopper, let's have a whopper, but get me to the church on time. I gotta be there in the morning, spruced up and looking in my prime. Boys, come and kiss me, show how you miss me, get me to the church on time. And if I'm dancing, roll up the floor. And if I'm whistling, me out the door. I'm getting married in the morning. Ding dong, the bells are gonna chime. Kick out the rumpus, but don't lose a compass. And get me to the church. Get me to the church. For Pete's sake, get me to the church on time. I'm getting married in the morning. Ding dong, the bells are gonna chime. Church, get me to the church. For Pete's sake, get me to the church.
The bells always ring for me when it comes to Rosemary Clooney, and that was Nelson Riddle helping her getting to the church on time, the great song from My Fair Lady. Hello, I'm Larry Maslon, your host for Broadway to Main Street here on 88.3 FM, Peconic Public Broadcasting, WPPB. Today I thought we would turn our sights on this whole issue of the marriage knot, not for any insanely particular reason, but spring is in the air, weddings start to happen. It's always, as Oscar Hammerstein once said, a lovely day for a wedding. And I do have several friends getting married, so it's putting me in the ring and canopy frame of mind. Marriages, of course, are central to dramatic literature. All the great Shakespearean comedies end in a marriage because it propagates society and all that dramaturgical highfalutin jazz. But weddings are also essential to American musicals because they provide either good act ones or good act twos or finales that are fun. And the whole issue of commitment and love is always makes for great contrast and fraught relationships. There's no musical really that deals more with marriage than Company, Stephen Sondheim and George Firth's show from 1970. Which dealt with a bachelor, they used to call them back then. Now you'd call him a single guy or even perhaps a metrosexual named Bobby, who's trying to decide who's the right person to marry and to whom he should make a commitment. And the idea of what marriage means really weaves like a tapestry all the way through Company. So here's Richard Mewins from a celebration at Carnegie Hall singing, I think, a beautiful version of what Bobby's waiting for, which is someone.
Someone is waiting, cool as Sarah, easy and loving as as Susan, Jenny. Someone is waiting, warm as Susan, frantic and touching as Amy. Joanne, would I know her even if I met her? Have I missed her? Did I let her go? A Susan sort of Sarah, a Jenny-ish Joanne. Wait for me, I'm ready now. I'll find you if I can. Someone will hold me soft as Jenny, skinny and blue-eyed as Amy. Susan, someone will wake me sweet as Amy, tender and foolish as Sarah. Joanne, did I know her? Have I waited too long? Maybe so, but maybe so has she. My blue-eyed Sarah, warm Joanne, sweet Jenny, loving Susan, crazy Amy, wait for me. I'll hurry, wait for me, hurry, wait for me, hurry, wait for me.
The idea of waiting for someone to come along who'd be the right person to settle down with is as old as the American musical. Here's a classic song from the 1930 Girl Crazy, in which Ira Gershwin talks about the marriage knot as wittily as anyone ever has. And here's Anita O'Day to sing it for us.
Old man sunshine, listen you, never tell me dreams come true. Just try it, and I'll start a riot. Miss Outlanders, don't you dare ever tell me he will care. I'm certain it's the final curtain. I never ever want to hear from any cheerful Pollyannas who tell you fate supplies a mate. That's all bananas. They're writing songs of love, but not for me. A lucky star's above, but not for me. With love to lead the way, I found more skies of gray than any Russian play could guarantee. I was a fool to fall and get this way. Hi, hi, ho, ho, alas, lackaday. Although I can't dismiss the memory of his kiss, I guess he's not, not for me. Knocking on the door.
2x4, but not for me. I know the luck of the game. I'm puzzled just the same. Was I the moth of flame? I'm all at sea. It all began so well. Ooh, what an end. This is the time when a fella needs a friend. When every happy plot ends with a marriage knot.
Do not adjust your set. That was Anita O'Day fading in and out on her very own, singing But Not For Me. The early part of a marriage story in a musical often deals with someone putting themselves out there emotionally to say, hey, you might not be the person you were dreaming of. I may not be Prince Charming or Princess Charming, but I think I could make it work for you. Here's a lovely song. Actually, when I think of the word marry in a musical number, oddly enough, this is the first song I think of. It's by Kander and Ebb, and it's from The Rink. And this young man, the character of Lenny, is proposing to the young Cheetah Rivera. And, you know, I'm not going to tell you who's singing it. Why don't you listen to its lovely melody and its amusing sentiment and see if we come up with the same name at the end of the song. So here is Marry Me from The Rink.
Good old Lenny, good old Lenny. They never call me Lenny or Leonard or Len, but always good old Lenny, since I can't remember when. Good old, Lenny. They only seem to know me that way. But good old Lenny has something important to say. Marry me, come on and marry me. Why not agree to be my blushing bride? I know the neighborhood would give its consent, and there's a cutaway I'm dying to rent. The day you marry me, give in and marry me. I really love you, see, we can't go wrong. That diamond in the star I could pay monthly for. Come on and marry me. Marry me. Marry me. Marry me, though you don't love me now, you will in time. You may not know it yet, but I'm the best you'll get. Wake up and marry me. Marry me.
Any guesses who that charming tenor was? It was the young Jason Alexander in the Rink. Jason is very musically talented. We all know him from Seinfeld and other television shows, but he was in Merrily We Roll Along, did The Producers in L.A. as well. So I'm going to talk a little bit about another kind of marriage, an artistic marriage that I'm happy to announce. Broadway to Main Street, as I'm sure you know, if you've listened, has a number of podcasts you can get from downloading at www.peconicpublicbroadcasting.org. But there's another movement we're going towards, another hands across the water, another great affiliation between two august institutions. I'm going to be hosting a series of three concerts this summer at the Guildhall at East Hampton. Yes, so Broadway to Main Street is moving to 158 Main Street, and we have three live concerts, July 8th, July 29th, and August 12th. So stay tuned. I'll be hosting it. Each event is going to have some of Broadway's best talent, and of course I'm going to shill this on the air as much as I can before we get to July 8th. But you may be hearing about Guildhall summer events any day now, so do keep an eye and an ear open for that. I have a strong feeling that, however it goes, our artistic marriage will be a lot better than the marriage of Candide and Cunegonde. So we'll hear from the original cast of Candide, Barbara Cook, and Richard Rounsenville, singing about how they may not see to eye, they may not see eye to eye in their particular marriage.
Soon, when we feel we can afford it, we'll build a modest little farm.
We'll buy a yacht and live aboard it, rolling in luxury and stylish charm.
Cows and chickens,
social worlds,
peas and cabbage,
ropes of pearls.
Soon there'll be little ones beside us. We'll have a sweet Westphalian home.
Some who will grow as rich as Midas. We'll live in Paris when we're not in Rome.
Smiling baby,
marble halls,
Sunday picnic,
costume balls. Ooh!
Apple pie.
I love marriage.
So do I.
Happy pair, oh happy we. It's very rare, are we agree? Oh happy pair, oh happy we. It's very rare, are we agree? Oh happy pair, oh happy we. It's very rare, are we agree?
Now, obviously, anyone who's read a newspaper or is attuned to the Western world in the last couple of years knows that marriage is now not the traditional old-fashioned affair it used to be. The American musical has not really dealt with the idea of same-sex marriage yet, as far as I know, except for one show, oddly enough, in the early 80s called Dance a Little Closer. Played only one night with a terrific Alan J. Lerner, Charles Strauss score. It was called Close a Little Faster. But one of the subplots was about a gay couple who went to Switzerland to get married all those years ago. So Alan J. Lerner was a pioneer in ways we didn't even realize. So this is Brent Barrett and Jeff Keller singing a song from Dance a Little Closer. And I want to use this moment to celebrate the marriage of two great friends of mine, Steve Blyer, the estimable artistic director of the New York Festival of Song, and Jimmy Russell. So I'm going to celebrate them. I just did. And then we'll have Frank Lesser give a little whimsical doff of the musical Fedora to the celebration of their event. But first, Brent Barrett and Jeff Keller from Dance a Little Closer.
Why can't the world go and leave us alone to enjoy this perfect day, passing the carefree time away all on our own. Why can't the world and its mess go and change its address to a far-off star somewhere, leaving us here to dance on air? Life has ever known. Why can't the world leave us alone?
Why can't the world go and leave us alone to enjoy this perfect day, passing the carefree time away all on our own? Why can't change its address to a far-off star somewhere, leaving us here to dance on air, free and alone? Let them rant and roar, throw all and more. Why should you and I attend?
Why not hang a sign out there on the line, say,
gently, marry the man today and train him subsequently. Carefully expose him to domestic life, and if he ever tries to stray from you, have a pot roast,
have a headache,
have a baby, have two,
six, nine,
stop, marry the man today, rather than sigh and sorrow, marry the man today and change his way,
change his way.
Marriage is, of course, a big commitment, and not only do Nathan Detroit and Skye Masterson need their arms twisted to get to the altar, but other characters do as well. I think the anthem for connubial ambivalence comes in Company, and here we're going to hear the 1995 revival. We're going to hear the beautiful Patti Ben Peterson, Danny Burstyn, and the Tony-nominated V.N. Cox, who gives for me the definitive version of Sondheim's Getting Married Today.
My shoes anywhere.
Today is for Amy. Amy, I give you the rest of my life to cherish and to keep you, to honor you forever. Today is for Amy, my happily.
We're really getting married.
Pardon me, is everybody there? Because if everybody's there, I want to thank you all for coming to the wedding. I'd appreciate your going even more. I mean, you must have lots of better things to do, and not a word of it to Paul. Remember, Paul, you know the man I'm going to marry, but I'm not, because I wouldn't ruin anyone as wonderful as he is. But I thank you all for the gifts and the flowers. Thank you all. Now it's back to the showers. Don't tell Paul, but I'm not getting married today.
His good cufflinks.
On the dresser. Right next to my suicide note. Listen, everybody, look, I don't know what you're waiting for. A wedding, what's a wedding? It's a prehistoric ritual where everybody promises fidelity forever, which is maybe the most horrifying word I ever heard, and which is followed by a honeymoon where suddenly you'll realize he's saddled with a net and want to kill me, which you should. So listen, thanks a bunch, but I'm not getting married. Go have lunch, because I'm not getting married. You've been grand, but I'm not getting married. Don't just stand there. I'm not getting married. And don't tell Paul, but I'm not getting married today. Go, can't you go? Why is nobody listening? Goodbye, go and cry at another person's wake. If you're quick for a kick, you could pick up a christening. But please, on my knees, there's a human life at stake. Listen, everybody, I'm afraid you didn't hear. Do you want to see a crazy lady fall apart in front of you? It isn't only Paul who may be ruining his life. You know, we'll both of us be losing our identities. I telephoned my analyst about it, and he said to see you Monday. But by Monday, I'll be floating in the Hudson with the other garbage. I'm not well, so I'm not getting married. You've been swell, but I'm not getting married. Clear the hall, because I'm not getting married. Thank you all, but I'm not getting married. And don't tell Paul, but I'm not getting married today. Die like Eliza on the ice, but perhaps I'll collapse in the abs right before. my shoes and boil
day
the rice. Look, I didn't want to have to tell you, but I may be coming down with hepatitis and I think I'm going to faint. So if you want to see me faint, I'll do it happily. But wouldn't it be funnier to go and watch a funeral? So thank you for the 27 dinner plates and 37 butter knives and 47 paperweights and 57 candle holders.
One more thing.
I am not getting married.
Said,
but I'm not getting married.
With this ring.
Still, I'm not getting married.
I mean,
see, I'm not getting married.
Let us pray
that we're not getting married today.
If you're a fan of V.N. Cox, and who isn't, you'll get to see her perform in our July 29th Comedy Tonight concert at Guildhall this summer. Well, it does take a long road for some people to get married. It took me a long road. My beautiful wife, Genevieve, and I actually eloped down to South Carolina. We actually got married 100 yards from where Gershwin wrote Porgy and Bess. What do you know? But had we gotten married, we would have done so in Long Island in one of the vineyards, and I was very keen to play the following song from Frank Lesser's Most Happy Fella. I don't know that Genevieve would have been so keen. She's not nearly the musical theater fan that I am, but of course I love her anyway. But here is one of the most beautiful songs from Frank Lesser.
It's that kind of night, a beautiful night. You can hear it in the air. All nature seems to know there are two lovers tonight. There are two lovers tonight. Hereabouts, all nature seems to know and sing her song, her tender song, that all is well. And all is right. Listen. Do you hear what I hear?
Do you hear what I hear? Do you hear?
Well, now we come to the incontrovertible event itself, the wedding. And musicals have used weddings at the end of the first act. Again, they've used them at the end of the second act. Here's a little wedding medley. We'll hear a Jewish wedding. Then we'll hear a wedding between a president and a first lady from the Gershwin-Kaufman musical Of Thee I Sing, from a concert version in 1997 with Larry Kurt and Maureen McGovern. And then we'll go to a Greek wedding, my big fat musical Greek wedding, Zorba, with Herschel Bernardi and Maria Kornilova from the 1969 musical. But let's go start the procession, the wedding procession, with one of the great family numbers of all time, Difficult Not to Be Moved. Of course, it's from Fiddler on the Roof, and we're going to hear that great Jewish singer, Sammy Davis, render it.
Is this the little girl I carry? Is this the little boy at play? I don't remember growing older. When did they? When did she get to be a beauty? When did he grow to be so tall? Wasn't it yesterday when they were small? Sunrise, sunset, swiftly flow the days. Seedlings turn overnight to sunflowers, blossoming even as we gaze. Sunrise, sunset, swiftly fly the years, one season following another, laden with happiness and tears.
Here's a kiss for Cinderella and a parting kiss for May. Toodaloo, goodbye, this is my wedding day. Here's a parting smile for Della and the lady known as Lou. Toodaloo, goodbye, with bachelor days I'm through. Though I really never knew them, it's a rule I must obey. So I'm saying goodbye to them in the customary way. My regards to Arabella and to Emmeline and Kay. Toodaloo, dear girls, goodbye, this is my wedding. And a parting kiss for May. Toodaloo, goodbye, this is my wedding day. Here's a parting glance for Gloria and the lady known.
the servant of God, Alexis, and the servant of God, Hortas, now affianced together, we beg salvation, O Lord. Represent her purity.
Did you hear that? Did you hear that? I'm pure.
Some water from the well to summon back his innocence. And cherries from the tree to show that she is married. She's absolutely married.
She's positively married.
She certainly is married as she'll ever be. Confetti we can throw to represent her happiness.
Exchange the rings and drink the wine and
I promise.
Ubelina.
I promise.
Amen.
Yasu, yasu, yasu.
Amen.
Yasu, yasu, yasu.
Amen.
Kiss you've ever had.
A wonderful celebration of a Greek version of the marriage knot from Zorba, score by John Kander and Fred Ebb. Kander and Ebb wrote one of the most touching songs about married for the musical Cabaret. So we'll go to two songs about, shall we say, the maturity of wedded bliss. The second is from I Do, I Do, the Jones and Schmidt musical based on the Four poster, which is all about marriage, originally starring Mary Martin and Robert Preston. And then we'll start first, though, with a song that makes me think of two good friends of mine in Watermill, who have finally settled down and tied the marriage knot, because I think of Frau Schneider, of course, played by Lotta Lenya. So here's a tip of the marriage hat to that couple, and we'll hear Jack Guilford and Lotta Lenya in Cabaret.
How the world can change, it can change like that, due to one little word, married. See a palace rise from a two-room flat, due to one little word, married. And the old despair that was often there suddenly ceases to be. For you wake one day look around and say, somebody wonderful married me.
How the world can change, it can change like that, due to one little word, married. See a palace rise from a two-room flat, due to one little word,
married.
And the old despair that was often there, suddenly
around and say, somebody wonderful,
somebody wonderful,
marry me.
constantly. I memorize moments that I'm fondest of. My cup runneth over with love.
In only a moment, we both will be old. We won't even the world turning cold. And so in this moment, with sunlight above, my cup runneth over with love,
with love.
Writers for musical theater, love, mature wedded bliss. There's that great song, The Folks Who Live on the Hill, by Jerome Kern and Oscar Hammerstein. It's from a movie, but one of the great songs ever written. As well as the score we heard from I Do, I Do. But anyone who's ever been married more than, oh, I don't know, 3 days, longer than Ernest Borgnine and Ethel Merman, will tell you that there are invariably arguments, sometimes about people from the past. And the musical version, the musical show High Spirits, based on Noel Coward's Blithe Spirit, takes that idea literally. Our hero, Charles Condamine, is actually being beleaguered by the ghost of his first wife, and it unnerves him a little bit. He's being a little cranky with his current wife, Ruth. Here's Edward Woodward and Louise Troy showing some cracks in the facade of a happy marriage from High Spirits.
quench in my hair. Who's this lass with the deadly air? The shrew I see is strange to me. She couldn't be the girl I married. She was sweet, she was swell. Now heaven has turned to hell. She's hard as nails and off the rails. Where is the girl I married?
He was Tweedy, now he's seedy. He looks so helpless, hopeless, and harried. I wonder what became of the man.
Of course, every married couple has to resolve their spats eventually, and so does that couple, in the right spirit, so to speak. Well, marriage isn't easy, but for those of us who stuck it out, it's certainly worth it. So today on Broadway to Main Street, we celebrate all those husbands and wives, and husbands and husbands, and wives for making that commitment. Here is my toast to my wife, Genevieve. And everything I could say to you, Frank Sinatra says pretty well himself from the title song of the musical, I Love My Wife. And again, a celebration to everyone tying a knot this spring.
My thoughts may stray, my eyes may roam, the neighbor's grass may seem much greener than the grass right here at home. If pretty girls excite me, well, that's life. But just in case you didn't know, I love my wife. My mind at times may dwell on sex. If someone's rating dreams, then most of mine, I guess, are double X. So dimple knees delight me, well, that's life. But just in case you hadn't heard, I love my wife. Like bait that wriggles, and it makes catfish bite. A lady jiggles, and my eyes got a light upon so sweet a sight. And if I shake, break out in spots, don't fret, it's not swine fever, dear. Your swine has merely got the hots. If rosy lips invite me, well, that's life. But just in case you couldn't guess, I love my wife. My mind at times may dwell on sex. If someone's rating dreams, then most of mine, I guess, are double X. If rosy lips invite me, well, that's life. But just in case you couldn't guess, or hadn't heard, or didn't know, I love my wife. I love my wife. I love my wife. I love my wife.
Well, where is the time all gone to? This is Larry Maslon here at Broadway to Main Street. Let's catch up next Sunday at 3.
There's so much more embracing still to be done, but time is racing. Oh, well, we'll catch up some other time.